Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Banker Zeta. Today is day 15 of Kar IBPS 2019 Fateh. Aaj ki file dialog based hai. Directions 1 to 5. Question number 1. No CPU is registered. No CPU is registered. No register is bus. All buses are transistors. Some transistors are not capacitors. So some transistors are not capacitors. Confusion 1. Some capacitors are bus is a possibility. So clearly, कोई direct relation नहीं है और possibility का case है, इसलिए ये हमारा true होगा. Second conclusion, no CPU is bus. Again, direct relation नहीं है और possibility नहीं है, इसलिए ये हमारा false होगा. Third conclusion, all transistors are capacitors is a possibility. हमें confusion में क्लियरली दिया गया है कि all transistors are capacitors. हमारे स्टेटमेंट में है कि some transistors are not capacitors. So clearly ये गलत हुआ confusion. इसलिए सिर्फ first confusion हमारा true होगा. इसलिए option A हमारा correct answer है. Only one confusion follows. Question number 2. Some primary are memory. Some primary are memory. All RAM are memory. All RAM are ROM. All RAM are ROM. No ROM is volatile. Confusion 1, no RAM is volatile. Clearly, सारा RAM ROM है और कोई भी ROM volatile नहीं है, इसलिए कोई भी RAM volatile नहीं होगा. ये confusion हमारा सही है. Second confusion, all memory are ROM. Some memory definitely ROM है, लेकिन all memory ROM है, के लिए अगर is a possibility होता, तो ये हमारा confusion सही हो जाता, लेकिन possibility का case नहीं है. इसलिए ये confusion हमारा does not follow होगा. Third conclusion, all ROM are memory is a possibility. So clearly ये भी हो सकता है. Some ROM memory है, तो all ROM memory भी हो सकती है और possibility case है. इसलिए ये confusion हमारा सही होगा. इसलिए option C, that is only first and third follows, हमारा correct answer है. Question number 4. Some mouse are not remote. Some mouse are not remote. Some remote are not battery. Some remote are not battery. All battery is projector. And some projector is not scanner. Some projector is not scanner. ये हमारा Venn diagram बनेगा. Confusion 1. All projectors are mouse is a possibility. कोई direct relation नहीं है और possibility है, इसलिए ये confusion हमारा follow होता है. Second conclusion. Some scanners are not battery. Scanners और battery में कोई direct relation नहीं दिया गया है, इसलिए ये confusion हम नहीं कर सकते conclude. Third conclusion, all projectors can be remote. So all projectors can be remote, the possibility का case है और direct relation भी नहीं दिया गया है, इसलिए ये conclusion हमारा follow होगा, इसलिए option A हमारा correct answer है. Question number 4, all pencils are pen, some pens are papers and some copy are papers. Clearly ये Venn diagram बनेगा. Conclusion 1, some pens are pencils. तो clearly Venn diagram से हमें पता चलता है कि some pens are pencils, इसलिए ये confusion हमारा correct होगा. Some pens are copy, कोई direct relation नहीं है, इसलिए ये हम नहीं conclude कर सकते. थर्ड कंक्लूजन, सम कॉपी आर नॉट पेन, अगेन कोई डायरेक्ट रिलेशन नहीं है, इसलिए ये हम कंक्लूड नहीं कर सकते. लेकिन जब सम एंड सम नॉट का केस होगा और हमारे एलिमेंट्स भी सेम हैं, इसमें आइदर और का केस लग सकता है, इसलिए ऑप्शन सी दैट इज ओनली फर्स्ट एंड आइदर सेकेंड और थर्ड फॉलोज हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. Question number 5, no aeroplane is bus. No aeroplane is bus. Some cars are aeroplane and some cars are bus. तो clearly हमारा Venn diagram बनेगा कुछ ऐसा. Conclusion 1, some cars are not bus is a possibility. Some cars are not bus is a possibility. तो clearly जो car aeroplane है वो bus नहीं होगा, ये definite है, लेकिन possibility case लगी है, इसलिए ये conclusion हमारा follow नहीं होगा. Second conclusion, some cars are not aeroplane. Again, जो कार बस है वो एरोप्लेन नहीं होगी, इसलिए ये कंक्लूजन हमारा फॉलो करता है. थर्ड कंक्लूजन, नो कार इज बस, अगेन सम कार डेफिनेटली बस है और सम कार डेफिनेटली बस नहीं है, लेकिन कोई भी कार बस नहीं है, ये हमारा गलत है, इसलिए सिर्फ सेकंड कंक्लूजन फॉलो करता है. ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. Directions 6 to 7. In the questions below are given some conclusions followed by some statements. You have to choose the correct set of statements that logically satisfy given conclusions definitely. Assume the given statements to be true even if they seem to be at variance from commonly known facts. Question number 6. यहाँ पे reverse dialogue है. Conclusion दिया गया है और statement हमें देखना है कौन सा correct होगा. सारे स्टेटमेंट्स को हमें देखना पड़ेगा. ऑप्शन ए, सम एफ इज सी, सम एफ इज सी, नो एफ इज ई, सम ई इज डी, ऑल ई इज बी, ऑल एफ इज ए. कंक्लूजन क्या है? सम ए इज बी. तो क्लियरली यहां से कोई डायरेक्ट रिलेशन नहीं है, इसलिए ये कंक्लूजन हमारा फॉलो नहीं होगा. सम डी इज सी, अगेन इसलिए ये स्टेटमेंट जो है हमारा नहीं हो सकता. सेकेंड ऑप्शन बी, सम बी इज एफ, सम बी इज एफ, ऑल एफ इज ए, no C is B, no C is B, all D is C, some E,
All C is E.
तो क्लियरली ये वेन डायग्राम बनेगा, सम ए इज बी, क्लियरली ये फॉलो होता है, और सम डी इज सी, ये भी फॉलो होता है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन 7, कंक्लूजन है ओनली एन एन आर एम. जब दिया गया है ओनली एन आर एम तो इसका मतलब होता है दैट ऑल एम आर एन. पहले ऑप्शन पे चलते हैं, सम के इज एम, सम के इज एम, नो एम इज ओ, सम पी इज ओ, ऑल एल इज एम, ये एल होगा, एंड ऑल एन इज एल. इस डायग्राम को थोड़ा क्लियर बना लेते हैं. All N is L, all L is M, no M is O, some K is M, and some P is O. ये बनेगा वेन डायग्राम. तो all M are N, ये कहीं से कंक्लूड नहीं होता है. Some O is P, ये होता है, लेकिन first हमारा नहीं होता है, इसलिए ये ऑप्शन हमारा नहीं होगा. दोनों हमारे सेटिस्फाई करने चाहिए कंक्लूजन्स. ऑप्शन बी, सम एम इज जे, सॉरी ऑल एम इज जे, ऑल एम इज जे, नो जे इज एन. तो क्लियरली ऑल एम आर एन वाला कंक्लूजन हमारा यहां से फॉलो नहीं होगा, इसलिए ये भी ऑप्शन नहीं है. ऑप्शन सी, ऑल एम इज एल, ऑल एम इज एल, ऑल एल इज एन. यहां से हमारा जो पहला कंक्लूजन है वो डेफिनेटली फॉलो होता है, नो ओ इज एन, सम एन इज पी. तो क्लियरली ये जो दूसरा है हमारा वो फॉलो नहीं होता है, इसलिए ये भी नहीं होगा हमारा स्टेटमेंट. डी ऑप्शन पे चलते हैं, नो पी इज के, सम एन इज पी, ऑल जे इज एन, ऑल एम इज जे. तो क्लियरली इसको भी थोड़ा क्लियर कर बना देते हैं, ऑल एम इज जे, ऑल जे इज एन. तो हमारा फर्स्ट कंक्लूजन तो इससे फॉलो होता है, नो सम एन इज पी, ऑल पी इज ओ. तो क्लियरली सेकेंड कंक्लूजन है वो भी फॉलो होता है, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. डायरेक्शंस 8 to 9, हमें स्टेटमेंट्स दिए गए हैं बहुत सारी और कंक्लूजन्स है दो. हमें देखना है कि इनमें से कौन सा स्टेटमेंट हमें ये कंक्लूड कर सकता है. फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट, ओनली ई आर डी, अगेन ऑल डी आर ई होगा इसका, ऑल डी आर ई, सम ई इज सी, सम एफ आर सी, ऑल सी आर बी. कंक्लूजन है ऑल ई आर डी, सॉरी ओनली डी आर ई, तो ऑल ई आर डी. तो पहला ही कंक्लूजन हमारा फॉलो नहीं होता है, इसलिए ये हमारा ऑप्शन करेक्ट नहीं है. सेकेंड, ऑल एफ आर डी, सम डी आर बी, नो बी इज सी, ओनली एफ आर ई, मतलब ऑल ई आर एफ. अगर फर्स्ट कंक्लूजन देखें तो ये डेफिनेटली फॉलो होता है, लेकिन अगर सेकंड कंक्लूजन देखें तो यहाँ पे सम बी डेफिनेटली डी है, लेकिन वो एफ है या नहीं ये कंक्लूड हम नहीं कर सकते, इसलिए ये भी ऑप्शन हमारा नहीं होगा। थर्ड, ऑल बी आर डी, सम सी आर डी, सम एफ आर ई एंड ओनली बी आर ई। ओनली बी आर ई मतलब ऑल ई आर बी, तो ई यहां होगा एंड सम एफ आर ई। तो अगर फर्स्ट कंक्लूजन देखें वो डेफिनेटली हमारा ट्रू है, और अगर सेकेंड कंक्लूजन भी देखें तो वो भी हमारा डेफिनेटली ट्रू है, इसलिए ऑप्शन सी जो है ओनली स्टेटमेंट थ्री हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है। क्वेश्चन नाइन, फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट ओनली ई आर सी मतलब ऑल सी आर ई, सम एफ आर ई, ऑल बी आर सी, एंड सम बी आर डी। तो ये कुछ वेन डायग्राम बनेगा। कंक्लूजन वन, सम डी आर सी इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, तो क्लियरली यहां पे सम डी डेफिनेटली सी है, इसलिए पॉसिबिलिटी केस हमारा नहीं हो सकता है, इसलिए ये ऑप्शन भी हमारा नहीं होगा। सेकेंड ऑप्शन, ओनली बी इज ई, अगेन ऑल ई इज बी, सम बी इज एफ, ऑल एफ आर डी, सम सी आर एफ, सम डी आर ई इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, अगेन ये डेफिनेट है इसलिए पॉसिबिलिटी केस हमारा नहीं होगा फॉलो। सेकेंड भी ऑप्शन हमारा गलत होता है। थर्ड स्टेटमेंट, ऑल सी आर एफ, ऑल डी आर ई, सम बी आर ई, नो ई इज एफ, नो ई इज एफ, ऑल डी आर ई एंड सम बी आर ई। अगर सेकेंड कंक्लूजन को देखें ऑल बी आर ई यहां से हम नहीं बता सकते हैं, एंड सम डी आर सी इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, अगेन कोई भी सी ई नहीं होगा, इसलिए कोई भी डी भी सी नहीं होगा, इसलिए ये दोनों कंक्लूजन हमारे नहीं होते हैं। फोर्थ स्टेटमेंट, ओनली ई इज सी, ऑल ई आर डी, नो डी इज एफ, अगेन और सम डी आर सी इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, यहां पर डेफिनेट है कि सम डी डेफिनेटली सी है, तो पॉसिबिलिटी केस अगेन हमारा गलत होगा, इसलिए ये भी नहीं होगा, इसलिए ऑप्शन ई हमारा दैट इज नन ऑफ दीज हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है। डायरेक्शंस 10 to 14, स्टेटमेंट्स, क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, सम ए आर बी, आर बी, ऑल बी आर डी, ऑल डी आर ई। तो अगेन ये वेन डायग्राम बनेगा। कंक्लूजन वन, एटलीस्ट सम डी आर ए डेफिनेटली ट्रू है, ऑल ई बींग ए इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी, अगेन डेफिनेटली सम ई आर ई, तो पॉसिबिलिटी की केस हमारा, सॉरी डेफिनेटली सम ई और ए हमारा है, तो पॉसिबिलिटी की केस जरूर सही हो सकता है क्योंकि ऑल ई बींग ए पूछा गया है। थर्ड कंक्लूजन, सम डी आर नॉट ए, तो अगेन ये नहीं हो सकता है, इसलिए ऑप्शन सी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है। क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, सम एम आर नॉट एन, सम पी आर एन, सम आर आर एम। तो ये वेन डायग्राम बनेगा हमारा। कंक्लूजन वन, All P or M is a possibility. Again, ये definitely कोई direct relation नहीं है, इसलिए ये conclusion हमारा follow होता है. Second, all N can be R. Again, all N can be R. कोई direct relation नहीं है, इसलिए ये भी true होता है. No M is N. कोई M N नहीं है, लेकिन कोई भी N N नहीं है, ये हम नहीं conclude कर सकते हैं. इसलिए option D हमारा correct answer है. Question 12. Only A or C. Again, all C are A. No A is B. And some D are B. Conclusion 1. All D being C is a possibility. Again, ये conclusion हमारा follow नहीं हो सकता, क्योंकि some D definitely A नहीं है और सारे C A हैं, तो ये हमारा conclusion follow नहीं होगा. Some A are C, again ये हमारा सही है. And some D are not C, again जैसे first में explain किया था. Some D जो है वो सी नहीं है, इसलिए हमारा सेकंड और थर्ड हमारा फॉलो करता है, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन 13. सम ए आर बी, सम ए आर बी, ऑल डी आर ई एंड ऑल बी आर डी, ऑल बी आर डी एंड ऑल डी आर ई. First conclusion, at least some D are not A. Again, ये हम conclude नहीं कर सकते हैं. All E are E, ये भी हम conclude नहीं कर सकते हैं. Some E are E, A. So clearly ये हमारा true है, इसलिए सिर्फ third conclusion हमारा सही है. Option C हमारा correct answer है. Question 14. No M is Q. No M is Q. Some R are M and some Q are R. So clearly R कुछ diagram फिर से बना लेते हैं. ये होगा some S are R. तो some S are R. Conclusion 1. सम आर नॉट क्यू. अगेन जो आर एम है वो क्यू नहीं होगा, इसलिए ये कंक्लूजन हमारा फॉलो करता है. सम आर नॉट एम. अगेन जो आर क्यू होगा वो एम नहीं होगा, ये भी कंक्लूजन फॉलो करता है. ऑल एस आर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी. अगेन सम आर एस जो है वो आर है, इसलिए सारे एस भी आर हो सकते हैं. पॉसिबिलिटी केस भी लगी है, इसलिए ये भी कंक्लूजन हमारा फॉलो होता है. ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. लास्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 15. कंक्लूजन है और स्टेटमेंट्स दिए गए हैं. रिवर्स डायलॉग अगेन, सारे देखते हैं स्टेटमेंट्स. ऑप्शन ए, नो पी इज सी, ऑल क्यू आर पी. तो ऑल क्यू आर पी, नो पी इज सी, सम ए आर क्यू, सम ई आर ए, सम ए आर सी. अगेन कोई डायरेक्ट रिलेशन नहीं है, इसलिए ये स्टेटमेंट नहीं हो सकता. सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट, ऑल पी आर क्यू, ऑल सॉरी ऑल क्यू आर पी, नो पी इज ए, तो जो हमारा फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट है दैट इज ऑल पी आर क्यू, तो ऑल पी आर क्यू नहीं हो सकता है. सम पी डेफिनेटली हमारा क्यू है, लेकिन ऑल पी क्यू नहीं है, इसलिए ये भी स्टेटमेंट नहीं होगा. स्टेटमेंट थर्ड, ऑल सी आर ए, ऑल सी आर ए, नो ए इज पी, All E are Q and all P are E. All P are E and all E are Q. तो सम ए आर सी डेफिनेटली हमारा इसमें फॉलो होता है एंड ऑल पी आर क्यू ये भी फॉलो होता है, इसलिए ऑप्शन सी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू bankers@adda.com। टुडे वी आर हियर, टुडे दिस इज द सेशन फॉर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड वी विल डिस्कस द इंग्लिश क्विज फॉर IBPS एग्जाम्स 2019 ऑफ 7th फरवरी। Okay, so this is the day 15 for our plan. Kar IBPS 2019 Fateh. It is a 6-month preparation plan going on. If you want to clear IBPS exams 2019 this year, you must start your preparations right on because the competition is not going to be really easy. Now let's see what is the topic for today's quiz. Today's quiz is based on sentence rearrangement. A sentence is given which is divided into four parts A, B, C, D. You have to rearrange them to form a meaningful sentence. These type of questions were seen in IBPS clerk pre, NIACL assistant pre and various other exams. So it is a very important topic and an easy one if you practice thoroughly. Let's see. If you see question one, for look at this CADB. Technological somnambulism is a concept used when talking about the philosophy of technology. Simple hai, CADB aapka answer hai. Next, agar aap dekhe iska opening statement dekhte hain. With the interim budget out, ho sakta hai. All eyes are now on the monetary. Ye bhi ho sakta hai. Par policy committees monetary ke baad ye aana chahiye, B ke baad C aana chahiye. Will be announced. That will be announced. ठीक है, तो इसके बाद डी भी सीधा आ रहा है, यानी आपका जो बन रहा है वो बन रहा है ए बी सी डी. नेक्स्ट ऑन कंजम्पशन, ये हो सकता है फर्स्ट. एक्सपर्ट सी अ रिस्क ऑफ इन्फ्लेशन, ये नहीं है, ये हो सकता है. सॉरी, फ्रॉम द एक्सपेंशनरी फिस्कल पॉलिसी, फिस्कल के बाद पॉलिसी आएगा. फोकसिंग एक्सक्लूसिवली, तो सी डी तो हो गया. अगर आप देखें ऑन कंजम्पशन फ्रॉम द एक्सपेंशनरी फिस्कल कुछ नहीं है. अगर आप देखें एक्सपर्ट सी अ रिस्क ऑफ इन्फ्लेशन, फिर फ्रॉम द एक्सपेंशनरी फिस्कल पॉलिसी फोकसिंग एक्सक्लूसिवली ऑन कंजम्पशन. सो दिस विल बी द करेक्ट सेट ऑफ रीअरेंजमेंट. नेक्स्ट देखते हैं, द इंडियन स्पेस रिसर्च ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज ऑल, होगा फर्स्ट वाला. इज ऑल क्या, सेट टू लॉन्च इट्स 40th कम्युनिकेशन सैटेलाइट. अब सैटेलाइट का नाम आएगा GSAT 31 ऑन फेब्रुवरी 6 फ्रॉम द स्पेस पोर्ट इन फ्रेंच गिना. ADCB ऑप्शन डी विल बी द आंसर. मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सो कॉल्ड एंजल टैक्स नहीं होगा. सून रिसीव सम कंसेशन. अगर आप देखें सी आपका ओपनिंग स्टेटमेंट होगा. यहाँ स्टार्टअप्स ट्रबल्ड बाय द सो कॉल्ड एंजल टैक्स मे सून रिसीव सम कंसेशन फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट. CABD आपका, CABD जो है यहाँ पर आपका मीनिंगफुल स्टेटमेंट बना रहा है. ओपनिंग स्टेटमेंट देखेंगे उसके बाद कनेक्ट करते जाएंगे. यहाँ अगर आप देखें सी को, अगर आप देखें ऑन मंडे द सेंटर हैड सेट अप अ 5 मेंबर क्या होगा वर्किंग कमिटी टू लुक इनटू व्हाट, टू लुक इनटू द टैक्स इम्पोज्ड ऑन स्टार्टअप्स रिवाइजिंग द नॉर्म्स ऑफ द, नहीं ये नहीं होगा, टू लुक इनटू रिवाइजिंग द नॉर्म्स ऑफ एंजल 6th वाले में आपका होगा. हाँ, to look into revising the norms of the angel the tax imposed on startups. In ye the yahan nahi aayega, of the angel tax imposed on startups, CADB. Next dekhte hain. If you see question 7, when you are traveling, whether for work or leisure, you are usually in a rush to catch the next flight and reach the destination. इसमें आपको कुछ भी करने की जरूरत नहीं है. अगर आप read करेंगे तो ABCD ही आपका correct निकल कर आएगा. Question 8. Now see, a short visit on your layover. Many countries have made it easy for Indians. अगर आप देखें तो B होगा. Many countries have made it easy for Indians to access their country, and this is why it becomes attractive to plan for a short visit on your layover. तो बी सी डी ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर चॉइस. क्वेश्चन 9, ओपनिंग स्टेटमेंट देखते हैं. इंडियन स्टैटिस्टिक्स ऑफन रिजेंबल अ हॉल ऑफ मिरर्स. उसके बाद क्या आएगा, दैट द बिविल्डर्ड हैव टू वॉक थ्रू. तो ए डी सी बी डी ऑप्शन हो जाएगा. क्वेश्चन 10, इफ यू सी आपका जो यहां पर होगा 10th में वो होगा सी, इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ इन फिस्कल ईयर 2017. फिर नेक्स्ट आएगा इज नाउ रिपोर्टेड टू बी 110 बेसिस पॉइंट्स हायर देन द प्रीवियस एस्टिमेट. तो आपका क्या आ रहा है, सी ए बी डी. बहुत इजीली हो जाते हैं क्वेश्चंस, आपको बस प्रैक्टिस करना होगा. अगर आप देखें सी को, टुडे इंडिया इज प्रोबेबली वन ऑफ द फ्यू लार्ज emerging economies, उसके बारे में बता रहा है, where growth and development seems to be cruising along at the same pace, making it unique in many ways. हो गया? C A D B. Next, Miss Selling has really gone out. Miss Selling की बात हो रही है. Really gone out of bounds, and so often I come across stories of people who have been duped. Simple. A B C D. Direct messages to user while awareness has been created through various media forms about phishing, it could be augmented by. अगर आप देखें आपका B बनेगा. While awareness has been created through various media forms about phishing, it could be augmented by direct messages to users. B, C, D, A. 14 देखते हैं. The mis-selling in insurance. ठीक है, पहला ही आपका ओपनिंग हो जाएगा इन इंश्योरेंस. फिर देखते हैं, हैज गॉन ऑन फॉर जस्ट टू लॉन्ग एंड नथिंग हैज बीन डन. आंसर विल बी ए डी सी बी. द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर द डे, इफ यू सी सी स्टेटमेंट सी, सम ऑफ द हार्डेस्ट मोमेंट्स ऑफ माई करियर वर फ्रॉम माई ईयर्स एज अ पीडियाट्रिशियन. ठीक है, पीडियाट्रिशियन की बात स्टार्ट हो रही है. व्हेन चिल्ड्रन केम टू माई क्लिनिक एंड आई लैक्ड ट्रीटमेंट टू क्योर देम और एग्जिस्टिंग ट्रीटमेंट वॉज पेनफुल अनरिलायबल और एक्सपेंसिव. इफ यू सी सी ए बी डी मेक्स अ कंटेक्चुअली करेक्ट सेंटेंस. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे सेशन. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.
Good afternoon friends, today we are going to discuss quantitative aptitude quiz based on time and work for IBPS, okay, 2019. So today is day 15 of Kar IBPS 2019 Fateh, okay. So the today's topic is time and work. So here there will be question based on time and work. Now we will see the questions. In the first question, A and B can do a piece of work in 72 days. B and C can do it in 120 days. A and C can do it in 90 days. In what time all of them can do it together? Okay. So A plus B, 72 days. B and C, 120 days. And A and C, 90 days. So ratio of efficiency will be, or we can say total work will be LCM of these three. So LCM of these three will be LCM of these three will be 72, 120, 90 here. Here 9 will be 4 will be common. So this is 18, this is 30, this here 3 will be common, so this is 3, so this is 24, this is 40, and this is 30 again. Here 10 will be common, so this is 24, this is 4, this is 3. And LCM of these three, 24, 4, 3 is 24. Okay, so this is 3 into 10 into 24, that is 720. This will be the LCM. So the total work will be 720. Okay. Now efficiency ratio of A and B will be this upon this. So this will be 10 and efficiency of this will be 6 and efficiency of this will be 8. Okay. So all of them when work together, so 2 times, because there is pair of 2, so 2 times A, B and C, this will be 720 upon sum of efficiencies, so this is 24, 10 at 18 and 6, 24, so this is 30. It means when 2 times of A, B and C, or we can say when A and B and C, all of them work in a pair, then total time taken by them will be 30 days. So by A, B and C will be total time 30 into 2, that is 60 days. Okay, so this is the required answer, and if you look at options, E will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number second. Here the second question is, A is thrice as good a workman as B and therefore is able to finish a job in 30 days less than B. How many days will they take to finish the job working together? So efficiency ratio of A and B is 3:1, and B takes, let time taken by B is X days, or we can say so time taken by A will be X by 3. So X minus X by 3, this is equal to 30. Okay, because efficiency of A is 3 times of B, so this will be equal to 3 equals to 30. So from here value of X will be 45. This is the time taken by B, so time taken by A will be 45 upon 3, that is 15 days. Okay, so the required answer or required number of days will be this will be LCM of these two, this is the time taken by A and B, and divided by total efficiency of both, that is 3 and 1, so 4, and LCM of these two will be 45 and 15, that is 45 divided by 4, this is 11 into 1 by 4 days. Okay, this is the required answer. So if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number third. In the third question, 9 men working 7 hours a day can complete a piece of work in 15 days. In how many days can 6 men working 9 hours a day complete the same piece of work? So the required number of days will be 9 men working 7 hours a day takes 15 days, and 6 men working 9 hours a day, so time taken by 6 men working 9 hour a day will be, this is 9 and cancel, and this is 2, and this is 5, so this is 35 by 2 days. Okay, so the required answer is 35 by 2 days, and if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 4th. In the fourth question, Bharat and Priyanka can do a piece of work in 45 and 40 days respectively. They began the work together, but Bharat leaves after some days and Priyanka finished the remaining work in 23 days. After how many days did Bharat leave? Okay, so here efficiency ratio of Bharat and Priyanka will be 1 upon 45, 1 upon 40, that is, this will be 4:5. Okay, sorry, here 8:9. Okay, this is the efficiency ratio because 5 is common in both, so this will be 9 here and this is 8. So 8:9 will be the efficiency ratio of Bharat and Priyanka. Now they begin work, but Bharat leaves after some days and the remaining work is finished by Priyanka in 23. So work done by Priyanka in 23 days, this will be efficiency of Priyanka and time taken by her, that is 9:23, and total work will be LCM of time taken by both 45 and 40, so 9:8:5, so this is 8:5, 40, and 9:40, that is 360 units. Okay, so here this will be 9:3, 27, and 9:2, 18, 18:20. This is the total work done by Priyanka when Bharat leaves. Okay, so the number of days after Bharat leaves. Bharat jitne dino baad work chhodta hai wo number of days will be like this. Total work 360 minus 207 divided by total efficiency ratio, total efficiency of both 8 and 9, that is 17. So this will be 3 and this is 5, this is 1 upon 17, so this is 9 days. Okay, so Bharat leaves after 9 days. So if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 5th. In the 5th question, Ramesh is twice as good a workman as Sunil and finishes a piece of work in 3 hours less than Sunil. In how many hours they together could finish that piece of work? So इस टाइप का क्वेश्चन मैंने पहले भी देखा था, इन प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन में किसी में था. सिमिलरली सेम उसी तरीके से एफिशिएंसी रेशियो ऑफ रमेश एंड सुनील इज 2:1. सो लेट टाइम टेकन बाय टाइम रेशियो विल बी 1/2 एंड 1. ओके, so here 1 minus 1/2, this is equal to 3 hours. So 1 unit will be equal to 3 into 2, that is 6 hours. It means Sunil takes 6 hours. So this is the time taken by Sunil and so time by Ramesh will be time taken by Ramesh. Time taken by Ramesh will be 6/2, that is 3 hours. So the required answer will be, required time will be when both works together, that is total work will be LCM of these two, 3 and 6, that is 6, and sum of efficiencies 2 and 1, 3, so 3, this is 2 hours, okay. So the time taken by both to finish the work will be 2 hours, and if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 6. In the 6th question, A and B can do a piece of work in 9 days and 18 days respectively. As they were ill, they could do 90% and 72% of their efficiency respectively. How many days will they take to complete the work together? Okay, so the efficiency ratio of A and B will be 9 days, so 1 upon 9, and this is 1 upon 18, so efficiency ratio will be 2:1, because A takes half time then B. Okay, now due to ill they could do 90% 72% of their efficiency, so new efficiency ratio will be new efficiency ratio will be 90%, means 90 upon 100, and this is 1 into 72 by 100, so this will be 180, and this is 72. Here 18 is common, so this is 10, and this is 4, or we can say 5:2. This is the new efficiency ratio of both, and the total work will be LCM of these two, that is 9 and 18, so this is total work. Here total work will be LCM of 9 and 18, so this will be 18 unit. Okay friends, so this is the total work, initial total work, or we can say original total work, but when efficiency decreases then total work will also be changed, or we can say in other words time taken by both will also be changed. So here if efficiency of first A will becomes 90%, it means time taken by A will be this will be 9, this was the initial time, into 100 upon 90, this is the percentage efficiency, or we can say efficiency of A. So here time will be 10 days because efficiency reduced, so time will be increased, and time by B will be, this is 18 into 100 upon 72, that is 25 days. Okay, here efficiency is reducing, so time taken by both will be increasing, so this is 25 days and 10 days, so in this case total work will be, now total work will be 10 into, or we can say LCM of 10 and 25, so LCM of 10 and 25 will be, this will be 50 unit. Okay, in this case total work will be 50 unit, and efficiency ratio is 5:2, so the required time 50 upon 7, that is 7 into 1 by 7 days. Okay, so if you look at options, A will be the right option. Okay, now we will move on next question, question number 7th. In the 7th question, B is twice efficient as A, and A can do a piece of work in 15 days. A started the work and after a few days, B joined him. They completed the work in 11 days from the starting. For how many days did they work together? So here, efficiency ratio of A and B is बी इज ट्वाइस इफिशियंट एज ए, 1:2, दैट इज इफिशियंसी ऑफ ए टू इफिशियंसी ऑफ बी. ओके, एंड ए कैन डू अ पीस ऑफ वर्किंग 15 डेज. सो टाइम टाइम रेशियो विल बी, और वी कैन से टाइम टेकन बाय बी विल बी 15/2, बिकॉज efficiency of B is twice the efficiency of A, so time taken by half. Now A started the work and after few days B joined him. So here this is the time. And A is 15 days. So let After x number of days, and they completed the work in 11 days. So let after x days b joined. So this will be x. And so total work done by A will be, A will work for 11 days and so here work done by B will be x by 15/2, that is 2x/15. This is the work done by B, and work done by A will be 11/15, because A will work for the total number of days, that is 11 days, and this is equal to total work 1. So from here this will be 2x/15, and this is 4/15. So from here value of x will be 2 days. It means B joined A after 2 days. So if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 8. In the 8th question, A can do some work in 24 days, B can do it in 32 days, and C can do it in 60 days. They start working together. A left after 6 days and B left after working for 8 days from start. How many more days are required to complete the whole work? Okay, so here efficiency, time taken by all of them is A, B and C, 24 days, 32 days and 60 days. So efficiency ratio, how we can say total work will be LCM of these three. So LCM of these three will be, here 4 is common, so this is 6, 8 and 15. Again 3 is common, so this is 2, 8 and 5. Okay, so here this will be 4 into 3 into 4, 0, because 285 LCM of 285 will be 4, 0. So total work will be 4 into 3, 12 into 4, 0, 12 into 4, 48, 480. Okay, so the efficiency of ABC will be divided by total time 24, this is 20, and this will be 48, 480/32, so 480/32 will be 30/2, that is 15, so this is 15, and this is 8, okay. Now A left after 6 days and B left after working for 8 days. So the required number of days, or we can say remaining work, required number of days, this is remaining work, remaining work upon sum of efficiency, that is 20 plus 15 35 and plus 8 this will be 43. Okay, so the remaining work will be, total work is 480 minus 6 days work of A, B and C. So 6 into sum of efficiency, that is 43 minus, and then A left, and the further 2 more days B and C work, and then B also left. So 2 days work of B and C will be 2 into sum of efficiency of B and C, 23. Okay, now B also left, so this is the this will be remaining work, sorry, and remaining work will be done by only A, sorry, by mistake, this was written as 43, the remaining work will be done by by C, because A and B have left, so the remaining work will be done by C, and this will be divided by 8, efficiency of C, so divided by 8. Now this will be equal to 6 into 43, so 6 into 43 will be 6 into 3 18 and 6 into 24 24 and 1 25 258, and this is 46, so this is 4 0 and 3, so 304, so this will be 480 minus 304 divided by 8, so this will be 2, this will be 6, and here this is 7 and this is 1 divided by 8, so this will be 2 and 2. Okay, so 22 days will be required by C to complete the remaining work, so the answer is 22, and if you look at option, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 9th. In the 9th question, P can cultivate 2/5 of the of the land in 6 days, Q can cultivate 1/3 of the same land in 10 days, working together P and Q can cultivate 4/5 of the land in. Okay, so here P will take total time to cultivate होल लैंड, कंप्लीट लैंड कल्टीवेट करने के लिए पी को कितना टाइम लगेगा, 2/5 वो करता है 6 दिन में, सो टोटल विल बी 6 इंटू 5 बाई 2, दैट इज 15 डेज. ओके, सिमिलरली क्यू, क्यू विल टेक 1/3 इन 10 डेज, सो टाइम टेकन बाई क्यू विल बी 3 इंटू 10, दैट इज 30 डेज. ओके, सो efficiency ratio of P and Q will be 2:1, and total work will be LCM of these two, that is 30 units. This is the total work. Okay, so 4/5 of the work will be 4/5, this will be 24 unit, so the required answer will be required time will be total work 24 and sum of efficiencies 2 and 1 3, that is 8 days. Okay, so the required number of days will be 8, and if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 10th. In the 10th question, A is 60% more efficient than B. In how many days A and B will working together complete a piece of work which A alone takes 15 days to finish. So here A is 60% more efficient than B. So time taken by A is, time by A is given 15 days, and efficiency ratio of A and B is, efficiency ratio of A and B 160, and this is 100. We can say 8:5. okay, that is time efficiency ratio of A and B. So time taken by B will be time by B, this will be, this is efficiency ratio. So ratio of opposite ratio of efficiencies will be time ratio. So this will be 15 into 8 by 5, that is 24 days. This is the time taken by B. Okay, so required time will be, required time, total work will be LCM of these two, 15 and 24. So here 15 and 24, 3 is common, so 3 into 5 into 8, so this will be 14 to 3, that is 120 units. So the total work will be 120 units and divided by sum of efficiencies, so this is 8 and 5, that is 13. So the required answer will be 9 into 3 by 13 days. Okay, so the required answer is 9 into 3 by 13 days. So E will be the right option. Okay, next question. Question number 11th. In the 11th question, A and B can do a piece of work in 28 and 35 days respectively. They both began to work together, but A leaves after some time and B completed the remaining work in 17 days. After how many days did A leave? Okay, so here efficiency time is given as time A and B. A takes 28 days and B 35 days. Okay, so the efficiency ratio of, or we can say from here total work will be LCM of these two. Yes, 7 is common, 7 into 4 into 5, this will be the total work. So 5 into 4, 20 into 7, 140 unit total work. So efficiency ratio will be this divided by 28, that is 5, and divided by 35, so this will be 4. So the efficiency ratio is 5 is to 4. Now required answer will be total work 140 and work done by B alone. Work done by B alone is 4 into 17, and this will be divided by total efficiency, that is 9. Okay, here, so this will be 17 into 4, 68, and this is 140, so 140 minus 68, 2, and this is 13 minus 6, that is 7. So 72 upon 9, that is 8 days. So A leaves after 8 days. So if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 12th. Question number 12th ka agar baat kare. In the 12th question, Ajit can do as much work in 2 days as Baljit can do in 3 days. And Baljit can do as much work in 4 days as Diljit can do it in 5 days. A piece of work takes 20 days if all work together. How long Baljit can do all the work by himself? Or we can say Baljit can do the total work alone in how many days? So here efficiency ratio will be Ajit and Baljit, efficiency ratio will be 3 is to 2, because time taken by Ajit is less than time taken by Baljit. Or we can say 2 days work of Ajit is equal to 3 days work of Baljit. So efficiency ratio of Ajit and Baljit will be 3 is to 2. And efficiency ratio of Baljit and Diljit will be, Baljit and Diljit will be 3 days of Baljit can do 4 days work at Diljit in 5 days, that is 5 is to 4. Okay, so the efficiency of efficiency ratio of all the three will be Ajit, Baljeet and Diljit will be, this will be 15, 10 and 8. Okay. Now time taken by Baljeet will be, this is the total time and efficiency ratio is 15, 10 and 8. So total efficiency will be 15, 10, 25 and 8, 33. So this is 33 divided by efficiency of Baljeet. So efficiency of Baljeet 10, so this is 10, so this will be 66 days. It means Baljeet will take 66 days to complete the whole work alone. So C will be the right option. Okay, next question. Question number 13th. In the 13th question, 25 men and 15 women can complete a piece of work in 12 days. All of them start working together and after working for 8 days, the women stopped working. Okay, 25 men completed the remaining work in 6 days. How many days will it take for completing the entire job if only 15 women are put on the job? So here 25 men and 15 women complete the work in 12 days. So total work completed by 12 men and women in 12 days. Okay, so 8 days work will be, because all of them start and work for 8 days, then women stop. So 8 days work will be 8 by 12, that is 2 by 3. So the remaining work will be, remaining work 1 minus 2 by 3, that is 1 by 3. So this is the remaining work which will be done by men only. So yeah, and this work will be done by 25 men in 6 days. So per day work of 25 men will be 1 by 3 into 1 by 6. This will be 1 by 18. Okay. So per day work of 15 women will be 25 men and 15 women work for 8 days, or we can say completed the work in 12 days. 55. So this will be 25. So 25 men and 15 women completed the work in 12 days. So per day work of 15 women will be 1 by 12. This is the per day work of men and women minus per day work of 25 men, that is 1 by 18. So here LCM will be 36 and this is 3 minus 2, that is 1 by 36. It means time taken by, that is required time to complete the work will be 36 days. This is the number of days which will be taken by 15 women to complete the whole work. So if you look at options, E will be the right option. Okay, next question. Question number 14th. In the 14th question, a man can type 20 lines in 10 minutes, but he leaves 8% margin in each line. In how much time will he type 23 pages with 40 lines on each page, leaving 25% more margin than before? Okay. So here, since one page contains 23 lines, let required time is x min required time is x minute. Okay, so here it will be, in first case margin is 8%, that is 100 minus 8. Okay, and it takes 10 minutes to type 20 lines, so this is 20 by 10. This will be equal to, in second case margin is 25% more than before, so 8% of, or we can say 125% of 8 will be 10%. So in this case margin is 10%, so here 10, and total pages will be 20 total lines will be 23 into 40, because 23 page with 40 lines, and the time taken by man is x. So from here this will be x is equal to 10 into 23 into 40 divided by 92 into 2. So here this is 4 and this is 10, so this is 100 upon 1 minute. Here this is 23, 1 minute, this will be 100 minus 10. Okay, this will be 100 minus 10 because 10% margin, so the remaining page will be 100 minus 10 into 23 into 40, so here this will be 90. Okay, so this is 90 into 10 divided by 2, that is 900 by 2, so this is 450 minutes. Okay, this is the required time to type the 23 pages containing 40 lines and leaving 10% margin on each, 10% margin on each page, or we can say each line. Okay, so here this is in minutes, so in hours this will be 450 upon 60, that is 7 hours and 30 minutes. Okay, this is the required answer, and if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 15th. In the 15th question, A can do 50% more work than B can do in the same time. B alone can do a piece of work in 20 hours. A with the help of B can finish the same work in how many hours? So here B takes 20 hours and A can do 50% more work. So efficiency of A and B will be, efficiency ratio of A and B will be 3:2. So time taken by A will be 2 by 3 into 20, that is 40 by 3 hours. Okay, so the required time will be, when A and B together work, required time will be 40 by 3 into 20 divided by 20 plus 40 by 3. So here 20 is common, so this is 1, this is 2. Okay, so this is 40 by 3, and here this is 1 plus 2 by 3, so this will be 3 by 5. Okay, so this will be 8, and time is in hours, so this will be 8 hours. Okay, so both will complete the work in 8 hours together. So if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay friends, so this is the end of this quantitative aptitude quiz based on time and work. I hope aap logo ko pasand aaya hoga, and agar pasand aaya hoga to please like and share kijiyega. Thank you so much for listening me, and best of luck for your exams.